Yes, my name is Vivek, and in this video tutorial we are going to discuss execute immediate statement and its relevance in PL/SQL. So as we have done in our previous videos, we are going to explain this with the help of real practical examples that I've used in my previous projects. So before I explain what exactly is execute immediate, which basically is used to run native dynamic SQL. So instead of going into those complex terminologies, let's quickly see a couple of scenarios and develop our understanding from them. That will be, I think, easier. So here I have an employee table that has three rows. Let me try to truncate this table just to verify if I have the access to truncate this table. So I can truncate this table. The table has been truncated, the data is gone. I will quickly repopulate the data, and this time I will try to truncate the table, but instead of doing it directly, I will try to do it as a part of an anonymous PL/SQL block. So if you try to execute a DDL statement inside an anonymous PL/SQL block or stored procedure, it's going to give you an error. Remember this, guys, I'm going to reiterate this once for you. If you want to execute a DDL statement in an anonymous PL/SQL block or stored procedure, it's going to fail if you do it directly, which brings the first advantage or the first usage of execute immediate. You can run a DDL statement inside an anonymous PL/SQL block or stored procedure using execute immediate. So let's see if it's going to work. So it says that the PL/SQL has, the procedure has successfully completed. Let's verify it. The data should have been deleted, which is the case. Let's quickly re-verify our results. The data has been inserted. We see the data. Let's run the anonymous PL/SQL block. It's completed and the data is deleted. Now guys, the first utility that we mentioned of execute immediate, it allows us to run the DDL statement inside stored procedure or PL/SQL block. But we may want to be a little careful while executing the DDL statements inside a stored procedure. So in my previous projects, I've created stored procedures that were used to truncate tables. They took, they were dynamic in nature. We used to pass the table name as a parameter and they used to delete the contents of that particular table. Similarly, I have used alter. So in case I want to enable the constraints before loading the table, I want to disable the constraints before loading the table and enable them after loading, I can use execute immediate, or I have used it in the past, and I've used alter in order to drop the partition or create the partitions. But at least I cannot think of any logical scenario which is a good design where I have created a table inside a PL/SQL block or dropped a table inside a PL/SQL block. That does not sound like a great design. Still, it is achievable if you want to create a table or if you want to drop a table inside a PL/SQL block. It's allowed using an execute immediate statement. It's just that you may want to use your brain to consider if it's a good design or not. But yes, the first advantage of execute immediate is it allows you to execute DDL statements inside a stored procedure or PL/SQL block, which otherwise is not allowed directly. So that's the first advantage that we gain from execute immediate. Let's come back to our second advantage, which actually is the definition or the primary purpose of execute immediate. So execute immediate basically is used to run native dynamic SQL. I will repeat that once for you. Execute immediate basically is used to run native dynamic SQL. Now, what is native dynamic SQL? We will again understand that with the help of a scenario. So let's say I have a problem statement here where I want to develop a procedure that will delete all the records from the table, but it has to be generic. I mean, the user will specify the name of the table at the runtime. So let's try to create such a procedure. So I'll create or replace procedure. The name of the procedure is table_delete, and let's specify the variable name as table name, which is varchar as. So now if I specify delete from table name, which is the name of the variable, will it accept it? So I got a compilation error here. Let me show you the error. So it said that it does not understand this table name. It says that the table or view does not exist. So it gave me a compilation error. It did not allow me to do that. So let's go back to the definition of dynamic PL SQL again, or execute immediate again. So execute immediate allows us to execute native dynamic SQL, and native dynamic SQL is something when you are executing a DML statement, but there are certain values of the variables which will be assigned at the runtime. So you want to update certain data, update a table, but you don't know the column name which is to be updated, or you don't know the where condition, a column used in where condition, stuff like that. So if you want to select, update, insert, or delete, even in DDL you can use that, but we will, for now we will stay with the DML. So if you want to execute a DML statement where there is a value that will be assigned at the runtime, like in this particular case table name, you cannot do it directly. You will have to use execute immediate in order to do it. So let's change this procedure and use execute immediate. And this delete from is a string while table name is a variable. So let's try to compile this procedure again. The procedure has been compiled. If you see here, the PL SQL has been successfully completed. The procedure has been compiled successfully and there is no error in the compiler log. Let's try to execute this procedure, and you can execute a procedure using this execute procedure name, and you pass the name of the table as the variable. So before that, let's quickly see if we have the data in this table. We don't have any data. Let's insert it. So the data has been inserted, verify it, and let's execute this procedure. So it says that the procedure has been successfully completed. That means the data should be deleted from here, which is the case. So which is good, we verified that. Now let's say we have another table. So I created another table from employee DC Viv, which is short for my name, Vivek. It has three rows. Now I don't have to make any changes to my procedure. I can just take this, pass it as a parameter, and these records will be deleted. So if I see here, we don't have any data. And guys, trust me, whenever I do any automation with PL SQL block, I extensively use this functionality where I create DMLs dynamically based on certain conditions and I execute them using execute immediate. I use them very frequently. I've written packages that compares data between different tables. I've written packages that can generate random data for an entire schema and I have done that using the help of these execute immediate. So I've used them extensively. I generate my SQL dynamically based on certain conditions, like whether it's a varchar, whether it's a number, whether it's a date, and using that I dynamically create my SQL and I execute that using execute immediate. So let's quickly recap the two usage or the two advantages, the two main advantages that we learned. The first advantage is, in case if you want to run a DDL statement inside a PL SQL block or a stored procedure, you cannot run it directly. You have to use execute immediate, which is what I showed here in the highlighted section. We truncated the table using this. The second advantage is, if you want to create a dynamic SQL, if you created a dynamic SQL in order to execute it as a part of PL SQL block or stored procedure, you need execute immediate. You cannot run a dynamic SQL directly. You have to use execute immediate. And what is a dynamic SQL? A dynamic SQL is a SQL where you are expecting certain variables to be passed at the compile time. You don't know all the variables in advance. Like here, table name is being passed by the user when executing the procedure. It may be through a drop down or an external procedure or command that's calling this. But these things are used extensively in automation and in real life projects. And these are the two main advantages. So hopefully it will be clear what exactly is execute immediate. It's used to run native dynamic SQL. What is that? What are the two advantages or two purposes of it? If you still have any doubt, please post that in the comment section and I'll try to reply as soon as possible. If you like this video, please do give it a thumbs up. It actually encourages me to make more such content. And to see my videos as soon as they are uploaded, please do subscribe to my channel. Thanks a lot, guys, for watching this video. Have a good day.